إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. أيها المؤمنون عباد الله، As the countdown begins to the end of the month of Ramadan, two things come to mind. First of all, the hadith, which is reported on the authority of Salman, where it is reported that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the month of Ramadan, شَهْرٌ أَوَّلَهُ رَحْمَةٌ. It is a month that the first part of it is mercy, وَأَوْسَطُهُ مَغْفِرَةٌ, and the middle part of it is forgiveness, وَآخِرُهُ عِتْقٌ مِنَ النَّارِ, and the last of it is being freed from the hellfire. And this hadith, Al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi, he declared it to be ضعيف بل منكر. It is a rejected, weak hadith, though you find it commonly being uttered on the tongues of many of the Muslims. And this is because it opposes, not only the chain of narration is weak, but it opposes other texts, such as the statement of Allah Azza wa Jalla when describing this month of Ramadan. He said, جَلَّ وَعَلَى يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah, He wants for you ease, and He does not want for you any difficulty. وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. In order for you to complete this appointed time, and in order for you to say Allahu Akbar, the days of Eid, and so you will be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah, He has mentioned about this month of Ramadan that He wants for us ease after legislating for us. So with the difficulty you're going through, the hunger and the thirst, then you know that this is still a rahmah from Allah Rabbul Alameen alayk. Likewise, with the month being a month of forgiveness, then the countless ahadith that many of us have memorized indicating this, such as the hadith of Abi Hurairah in Bukhari and Muslim, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands the month of Ramadan in iman and seeking his reward with Allah Azza wa Jal, he will be forgiven of that which preceded. Likewise, من صام رمضان. This is also the state for the one who fasts the month of Ramadan. And likewise, من قام ليلة القدر. The one who stands the night of ليلة القدر with iman and ihtisab, with iman and seeking your reward with Allah, you will be forgiven for that which preceded. So the entire month is a month of forgiveness. من أوله إلى آخره. And likewise, العتق من النار, Abu Umama رضي الله عنه, the noble companion, reports from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that he said, إن لله عتقاء من النار عند كل فطر, that Allah, He has those He sets free from the hellfire at every time the fast is broken. The hadith is collected by Ahmed and was declared حسن by الوادعي في صحيح المسند. So every day that you are fasting, at the time you break your fast, there are people that Allah chooses to set free from the hellfire. People that Allah, He has chosen to forgive of their sins. And these are people that Allah Jalla wa Ala, He has had mercy upon. فَأَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. This is a month, whether we realize it or not, that the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jalla is surrounding us. This collective gathering in congregation that we pray the Qiyam al-Layl in, just outside the month of Ramadan, if we were to gather on the first of Shawwal, the day of Eid, or any other day of the year, collectively gather to pray with the intent of praying in congregation like this after Isha, the ulama mentioned that this is an innovation. This is an innovation. But when it is in the month of Ramadan, then this is a sunnah. فَأَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. What is stopping us from taking part and taking advantage of this? The opportunity is there, like we continue to mention, for those who are seeking the pleasure of رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. The other thing that comes to mind is, as the month continues to dwindle away, and we're finding that the last 10 are fast approaching, many of us, the same eagerness and enthusiasm and the zeal we had when we came into the month of Ramadan, we find that it's not there. We were there in the beginning of the salah, touching the takbiratul ihram. We were there sitting prior to the salah. We were there reading Quran, ajza, portions of the Quran. Where has it all gone already? You look at those who are coming to the jama'ah, few in number in comparison to the first few nights. And this is wallahi a matter of gravity. If this is our state now, what will our state be in the last 10? And what will our state be after Ramadan? Questions need answers. It is worse off when we make promises to Allah that, oh Allah, if you allow me to live till next Ramadan, I'm going to really take advantage next year. And here you are. Perhaps some of us have made this promise to Allah, and the month is upon you. وَأَنْتَ كَمَا كُنْتَ فِي الْعَمِ الْمَاضِي. And you are just like you were last year. Where's the truthfulness to Allah? Allah Jalla wa'ala, He tells us about a people that He punished because they made promises to Him and they did not fulfill their promises. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهِ لَإِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. From the people of those who say, oh Allah, if you are to give us from your grant, from your bounty, from your givings, we will be from those who give and we will be from the righteous. فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. Then when Allah, He gave them, what did they do in return? When Allah gave them, they became stingy. They didn't want to give. And they turned away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promise. Allah azza wa jalla tells us about these people. فَأَعَقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ إِلَى يَوْمِ يَلْقَوْنَهُ بِمَا أَخْلَفُ اللَّهَ مَا وَعَدُوهُ وَبِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He struck in their hearts nifaq. He struck in their hearts hypocrisy due to the false promises that they were giving to Allah and due to the lies. This can be a reason of punishment from Allah that you say, oh Allah, give me this opportunity. And when the opportunity is granted, you're not taking advantage of it. And you are as you were before. أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. If you were to look at the example of the Sahaba, they were never like this. And this is why Allah, He elevated them. Anas ibn Malik, he reports in Sahih, a beautiful story showing us how truthful the Sahaba were. His uncle Anas ibn Nadhr. Anas ibn Malik, he reports, and this Sahabi Anas ibn Nadhr, many of us may not know about him, may not know much about him, but he was a rajul min as-salihin as-sadiqin. He was a truthful, righteous man. وَكَانَ إِذَا أَقْسَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَبَرَّهِ. And he was a man that if he said, wallahi, this is not going to happen, that Allah, He would make his oath a reality. Like when his auntie, she broke the tooth of a worker girl in her household. She broke her tooth. She became angry perhaps and struck her, and she broke her tooth. Then it's qisas fil Islam. If you break someone's tooth or chip their tooth, it's a tooth for a tooth, an eye for an eye. The family came requesting their haqq. This sahabi, he heard that his auntie's tooth was going to be chipped or broken. He said, Ya Rasulullah, ataksiru sin amati, O Messenger of Allah, are you going to break the tooth of my auntie? Wallahi, her tooth is not going to be broken. The family came back and they said, we have forgiven her. Look at how Allah Azza wa Jal makes a reality the oath of certain people due to their iman, due to their taqwa. Ayyuhal mu'minuna, this same sahabi, he did not take part in the battle of Badr. And he said, لَإِنْ يَسْرَ اللَّهُ لِي أَوْ لَإِنْ قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ لِي لِقَاءَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ لَيَرَيَنَّ اللَّهُ مَا أَصْنَعُ. If Allah, He decrees or writes for me that I meet the disbelievers, He will see what I'm going to do. And he took part in the battle of Uhud. فَلَمَّا انْكَشَفَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ, when the Muslims began to retreat, to go back, he said, Ya Allah, oh Allah, I ask pardon for these people. And he said, أَتَبَرَّوْا إِلَيْكَ مِمَّا صَنَعَ هَؤُلَاءِ. I free myself from what these mushriks, these disbelievers are doing. Then he was met by Sa'd bin Mu'adh. Sa'd bin Mu'adh. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَنْ سَعْدْ. What will make you know who Sa'd is? This noble sahabi. He was a leader of the Aus. The one that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about him. إِنَّ عَرْشَ الرَّحْمَنِ اهْتَزَّ بِمَوْتِهِ. That the throne of Allah Rabbul Alameen, it shook when he died. This is the sahabi Sa'd bin Mu'adh. These are our leaders. These are the people who we should be looking up to, not these footballers and musicians. And these people we consider to be stars, and they're nothing with Allah Rabbul Alameen. This noble sahabi, the arsh, the throne of Allah, shook when he passed away due to the status he had with Allah, due to the greatness he had, and the iman, and the munafiqoon. They said, ma akhaffa janazata. How light his janazah is. How light. They were insinuating that he has no real weight. Look how light his body is. Then the messenger told the sahaba to tell them, Al-Malaika hamalatu, the angels of Allah were carrying his janazah. these are the people we should be looking up to. We do not know about our history. We do not know about our leaders. But we know about the farag, as-sakit, the losers of this life. This is what we go back to in the time when we break our fast. Or maybe when we're fasting, we're on the YouTube and these platforms, watching people who have no qima and the Rabbil Alameen, people who have no value. And we don't want to learn about our deen. We don't want to learn about these people. How are we going to be successful if we do not know where we came from? If you do not know where you came from, how will you know where you're headed? He was met by Sa'd bin Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. And then he said to him, Anas bin Nadhr said to him, O Sa'd, wallahi inni la'ajid riyh al-jannah dun al-uhud. Wallahi, the smell of paradise, it is coming from me from in front of the mountain of Uhud. He cast himself in front of the enemy alone. Sa'd bin Mu'adh, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I was not able to do what he did. He cast himself in the front of the enemy and he was struck and killed. They found him afterwards, over 80 strikes on his body from being pierced with a spear and being poked with a sword. Radiallahu anhu arda. Was he not truthful to Allah? Wallahi, he was truthful. He said, Allah, if he gives me an opportunity, I will show him what I will do. And he did what he promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ مَثَّلُوا بِهِ And they mutilated him. So much so that no one was able to recognize him إِلَّا أُخْتُهُ except his sister. بِبَنَانِهِ through his fingers. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Only his sister could recognize him through his fingers. Imagine what mutilation they did to his face. وَلَكِنْ what does it benefit them? هُوَ رَجُلْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ He's a man of paradise. And the point being from this is to realize when the opportunity is placed in front of you, to take advantage of it, especially if you promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the people are two, those who fulfill and those who do not fulfill. For this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He revealed in relation to Anas ibn Nadhr, مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا أَحَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ From the believers are those who fulfill their promise to Allah. فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا From them are those who fulfilled their covenant to Allah, their promise they fulfilled it. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ And from them are those who are waiting. وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا And they did not make any changes to the promises they made to Allah رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ What needs to be discussed is how can we take advantage? The last 10 are fast approaching. What are we going to do to take advantage? We wanted to mention some ways that every believer, inshallah, will be able to use them and utilize them to take advantage of what is in front of you. From the first of these ways is to have a nizam fi yawmik. Have a schedule in your day. If you do not have a schedule, you find that your targets are not being met and you find yourself falling behind. But if you are to make for yourself a schedule that you're going to fulfill this amount of recitation of the Quran and you're going to pray this amount of sunan and you're going to do this amount of khairat, then you strive in achieving this. You make your target and try to fulfill. And this has an asl. This has a foundation in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Abu Darda, who was a man of ibadah, he married a woman and he was so busy with his ibadah that he was not giving her full attention. And she was met by his brother Salman al-Farisi. As this was the practice of Islam in the beginning when they migrated to Al-Madinah, Al-Ikhah, that the Prophet would make brothers between the Muhajirin and the Ansar. So the Prophet made brotherhood between Salman al-Farisi and Abu Darda, a man of Persian descent and a man who was an Ansari. Look how Islam brings together the hearts. So when he met his wife, and she said, he's a righteous man, ولكن he has not drawn near me. Then he came to visit him. He met him and he was fasting. He told him, break his fast. When it was time for the Qiyam al-Layl, he told him, sleep. When Abu Darda woke up, he told him, sleep. When he woke up again, he told him, sleep. Then they woke up and they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. And like this, then Salman told him, إِنَّ لِرَبِّكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ وَلِزَوْجِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ وَلِنَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ فَأَعْطِي كُلَّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقَّ Verily, Allah, He has a right over you. And your wife, she has a right over you. And your body has a right over you. Give everything its right. Give everyone its right. So he took from this that he was being advised and he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to verify. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Sadaqa Salman. Salman, he has spoken the truth." Radiallahu anhu arda. So you take from this, everything has a right on you. If you neglect the right of Allah, whose right can you fulfill after that? The prayer is being established. ونحن في بيوتنا. We're in our houses, perhaps doing whatever we're doing. Fulfill the rights of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Make a schedule and a target for yourself. And from the best ways that will help you fulfill these rights is for you to take companions of khayr. Good companions. فَإِنَّ الْمَرْءَ عَلَى دِينِ خَلِيلِهِ. A man is upon the religion of his companions, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. And the best places to find Ahl al-Khayr, the people of goodness, are in the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Besides the salawat, you find even in Ramadan that between the prayers, the houses of Allah are relatively empty. Take advantage and come to recite the book of Allah. To recite, draw near Allah Azza wa Jal. Take for yourself a translation like Muhsin Khan and Taqiyuddin al-Hilali. Read the translation while you're reading the Quran. Take advantage of your time. Take advantage. For indeed, these houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, أحب البلاد إلى الله مساجدها. The most beloved of places to Allah are the masajid, the houses of Allah. وأبغض البلاد إلى الله أسواقها. And the most hated and detested of places to Allah are the marketplaces. There's little dhikr, there's little remembrance of Allah, there's little tasbih, there's much lying and cheating and saying, Wallah, this is how much I paid for it. And the person is just lying, even if the name of Allah Azza wa Jalla is being used to sell commodities. So these are the most detested of places, the marketplaces. Yet we find ourselves already Eid shopping, and hours are being invested in Eid shopping. Things that can be done over a course of days if you have to, in order for your schedule to remain intact. If it was a worldly advantage or worldly profit and gain you were looking for, you would not hesitate. That's why we're looking for these deals today. We're looking for the Ramadan discounts and the Ramadan bargains. As even the kuffar, they have come to know of this. And you find mannequins in their shops of what is supposed to be Muslim attire of a woman, and she's wearing a dress and a head covering, which is not in actuality the Muslim covering. ولكن they know that the people are looking for bargains at this time. So we've already started. But who from us is actually trying to bargain with his soul to direct it to the right path of Allah Azza wa Jal and to strive in achieving his pleasure? Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillah, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira. Amma ba'd, ayyuhal mu'minuna ibadallah. Aisha radiyallahu anha, she reports about our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, annahu kana yajtahid fi ashr al-awakhir min Ramadan ma la yajtahid fi ghayrih. That he, alayhi salatu wasalam, would strive so much so in the fast, in the last 10 of Ramadan, that he would not do in any time of the year. Now imagine the effort that some of the akhiyar are putting in, the righteous and those who are making their efforts to draw near Allah Azza wa Jal. If we have not yet completed the mushaf, there are those who perhaps have completed thrice, four times, five times, maybe even more than that. Some of them are finishing the book of Allah every 3 days. Where will we be and where will they be? If Allah makes us from the people of paradise. وَنَسَلَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أَنْ يَجْعَلْنَا جَمِيعًا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. We ask Allah to make us all from the people of paradise. But the paradise is levels. Where will we be and where will they be? We have not yet completed the mushaf and they have completed maybe a number of times over. أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. This affair of sincerity to Allah and devotion. This is from the things that will help you take advantage of this month. When you realize what opportunity is in front of you, you will take it bi-idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the ways that will help you, besides what we've mentioned so far, is for you to lessen your intake of food. The food, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, though it is a ni'mah and a blessing from Allah, he still told us, مَا مَلَا آدَمِيٌ وِآءٌ شَرًّا مِنْ بَطْنِهِ. That the son of Adam has never filled a vessel which is more evil than his stomach. بِحَسْبِ بْنِي آدَم مِنَ الْأُكُلَاتِ مَا يُقِمْنَا صُلْبَهِ. What is sufficient for the son of Adam from food is that which will keep his back upright. فَإِنْ كَانَ لَا مَحَالَ. If there is no escape, فَثُلُثْ لِطَعَامِ وَثُلُثْ لِشَرَابِ وَثُلُثْ لِهَوَاء. And if there is no escape, then a third for food, a third for your drink, and a third of air. This will be something that if you were to practice it and try it, you will notice you have more energy, you will find more zeal, you will find more enthusiasm. As filling our stomachs, it prevents us from the qiyam. You're not able to pray like you want to pray. Likewise, it prevents us from waking up on time. As your stomach is full and this leads to the sleep becoming sweet with you, so you continue up until Fajr escapes you. If Fajr is escaping us now, at a time when Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us and surrounded us with rahmah, what will be our state beyond this month? Lessen your food and intake, and you will see that this is from the khayrat, bi-idhnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala, rabbil ardi wa samawat. Ayyuhal mu'minuna ibadallah. Another way that will help us in taking advantage of this month, which is from perhaps the greatest ways, is al-isti'ana billah, seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, I've seen this even with my own self. That the more you turn back to Allah, and you're asking Allah, Allahumma inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Oh Allah, assist me in being thankful to you. And oh Allah, assist me in your worship and perfecting it and your remembrance. The more you do this with sincerity, asking Allah, you find that opportunities are being granted to you to fulfill the ibadah. So we're in need of the assistance of Allah. And take from ibadat that which you're able to fulfill. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, عليكم من الأعمال ما تطيقون. Take upon yourself to do actions that you're able to fulfill. فأيها المؤمنون, seeking assistance and knowing a portion of ibadah that you're able to do, for you to be consistent with a few raka'at in the night is better than praying the entire prayer and then leaving off for another few days. As every night is an opportunity for maghfirah wa rahmah, the forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jal in His pardoning. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His beautiful names and attributes to benefit us from that which we have heard. اللهم نسألك بأسمائك الحسنى وصفاتك العلى أن تجعلنا مباركين موفقين في الانتفاع من هذا الشهر المبارك الكريم. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم وفقنا وسددنا وأعنا على طاعاتك. اللهم قنا شر أنفسنا وشر الشياطين الجن والإنس. والحمد لله رب العالمين.